your dreams? While you're awake?
Who's afraid of the boogeyman? You might not be, but there are many scary dream-related events that will have many of us waking up in a cold sweat, hoping that whatever happened in the dream stays in the dream. Now, if you've ever experienced any of these crazy, nightmarish dreams that I'm about to talk about, don't worry, you're not alone. Many other people have shared the exact same experience. So with that said, let's take a look at 10 of the most common nightmarish dreams. Alright, so before I jump right into things, I want to know from you guys. Are you afraid of the dark? Go ahead and leave your comments in the comment section below. Also, using that same comment section, let me know who or what you'd like me to find some interesting facts about next. Alright, so let's dive right into our list. Number 1. Falling. Many people from around the world have reported having dreams that have them falling into a never-ending abyss, which brings to life the saying, "I'm falling and I can't get up." Very few people have actually said to have hit the ground after falling from incredible heights. Kind of reminds me of a scene from The Matrix where Neo was supposed to jump from one building to the next but didn't quite make it, crashing to the ground below. Now, people who have said to have these dreams of themselves falling usually wake up before actually crashing to the ground. And it's said that if you have one of these dreams, or if it's recurring, it represents a lack of control. Number 2. Decaying teeth or having your teeth fall out. Don't worry, you don't need a dental plan just yet. It's just a dream. This common occurring dream has the dreamer feeling as if they have lost most or all of their teeth. This can be particularly scary, especially if you're young. Waking up with no teeth is no fun. Like, how are you supposed to eat your favorite food or bite into that delicious apple? It's not gonna happen without teeth. But that's right, it's only a dream. Now, the common belief here is that if you have one of these dreams of losing your teeth, you're probably suffering from anxiety or you're really stressed. Number 3. Feeling trapped. This dream usually has the person locked up somewhere in a confined area. Dreams about being trapped are quite commonly experienced by people who are claustrophobic, meaning there's fear or anxiety when they're placed in tight, closed spaces. Though it may not seem like a big deal, the people who actually experience this will tell you otherwise. They say if you're having one of these dreams, you're feeling trapped. And by that they mean feeling trapped in a situation you know you need to leave. So get going, leave if you must. Otherwise, these dreams will continue haunting you. Number 4, being naked. Ever had that weird feeling that everyone was looking at you but you didn't know why? And then you look down on yourself and realize that you're naked? According to EnkinVillage.com, psychologists argue that these dreams are symptoms of an inner fear, of what other people might believe or say about us, particularly about our physical appearance. Although the fact that being naked can also be perfectly seen as an allegory. Number 5. Major injury or deformation. Broken bones, smashed faces, deformed hands, all of this are part of the same, where many people report having dreams where they've experienced some kind of traumatic accident, where they've gotten some major kind of injury. Some people even eventually wake up with bruises on themselves, making their dreams even that much more real. Doctors and nurses say that these kinds of dreams are common in hospitalized patients especially. They say that it represents a feeling of weakness or powerlessness. But geez, imagine waking up with a scar from something that happened in your dream. That's pretty damn freaky. Number 6, being chased. This is by far the most common nightmarish dream that people have, being chased by something or someone out to get you. And this has been experienced by both young and old. It's said that these types of dreams are a result of being afraid of confrontation regarding something in your life. This could be anything from a relationship, your parents, to a negative situation in your life. It varies depending on who it is that you are. Now, how you react in the dream is said to reflect how you were dealing with the situation in real life. So next time you find yourself being chased, stop, turn around, and face whatever is chasing you, and you'll change the outcome of your dream. Number 7. Catastrophe or natural disaster. Earthquakes, tornadoes, buildings collapsing, volcano eruptions, you name it. These kinds of catastrophic natural disaster dreams are very common. Dreams of this kind will have the person running for their life, trying to get shelter in whatever way possible. It's even worse when you're a parent and you have children. You're likely to envision having to cater to your children while in distress, and these types of dreams are generally understood in the scientific community as revealing a feeling of anxiety or fear. Number 8. Night terrors. Have you ever experienced that feeling where you're pinned down, unable to speak or hardly breathe? You feel very awake, but you're struggling with what it seems to be an invisible or at least a dark-looking shadowy entity. Yeah, you're having a night terror. Another popular name for this is sleep paralysis. Now, according to NHS.UK, sleep paralysis is a temporary inability to move or speak that happens when you're waking up or, less commonly, falling asleep. Although you're awake, your body is briefly paralyzed, after which you can move and speak as normal. Now, this is probably the most terrifying kind of nightmare, though most don't consider it a nightmare at all. Some others believe that there's demonic activity involved in night terrors and report vivid accounts of their experience. Either way you look at it, it'll scare the life out of you and usually lasts for several minutes. But in the end, there's still no definitive answers as to why this happens or the meaning behind all of it, though some do claim that it's caused by a lack of sleep, depression, and extreme stress. Number 9. The end of the world. It's the end of the world and you know it, in your dreams at least. Depending on your religious affiliation or belief in what the end of the world is, the dream may manifest in many ways. You could wake up in your dream and realize that the sky has rolled back and witness Jesus' return. Or maybe you'll realize that everything around you has been totally destroyed and that you're probably the only person around, as you wander around in what is now a wasteland. According to Glow.com, to dream that it is the end of the world suggests that you're under a tremendous level of stress, or you may be feeling vulnerable or helpless in some situation. Number 10. Seeing dead people.
I see dead people.
The famous line from the movie The Sixth Sense, starring Bruce Willis and Haley Joel Osment, has proved to be true for many people, at least in their dreams. Where in it, there's a manifestation of what could be a dead relative or someone you might not have known personally. These manifestations of the dead could be something welcoming, but many other times it could be downright terrifying. And in the dream, it's often known that the person or entity that you're interacting with is actually dead. Now, it's said that these types of nightmares could be associated with the inability to let things go, particularly letting go of someone in your life who's passed away. So whatever it is that you're holding on to, just let it go. All right, so before I wrap up, please go ahead and hit the comment section below and let me know if any of you guys have ever experienced any of these dream and nightmarish events. So let's go ahead and talk about it and let's have a discussion. And just like that, there goes another episode. So if you're new to this channel, do me a big favor and smash the subscribe button. Give this video a thumbs up, and you know I love your comments, so leave your comments in the comment section below. And don't forget to check out www.theyoutubebuzz.com, where you can then click on the store button and purchase your very own YouTube Killed TV t-shirt. Also, check out the new Facts on Archive channel, where I just have a whole archived video section simply just for Facts on videos. I've got links to that in the description box below. And if you guys want to stalk me on social media, I'm available on Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, and Google+. And I'm also on Instagram. And that's pretty much it. This video is a wrap, and I'll catch you guys in the next episode.